If you've been on my channel for a long time, you'd know that I made my own graphics card from scratch, called the Turtle Card 100X, with the X standing for extremely terribly designed. After that, I made the Turtle Card 150X, which had some minor improvements like being able to play 8-frame videos. But these two graphics cards had one major problem. You see, in order for something to be called a graphics card, it needs to be able to do some sort of processing. And sadly, displaying pictures onto a screen isn't considered processing. So to fix this, I'm going to build the Turtle Card 200X 3D and try to get it to render 3D objects. Before we can get building, we first need to understand 3D rendering. If you look closely at the sphere, you'll realize that it's made of hundreds of squares, which are each made of lines. The same thing applies to this cube and the cylinder. So, in order to render 3D objects, all we really need to do is to draw a lot of lines in a three-dimensional space, which is actually harder than it seems. Since computer screens are made up of pixels, we would need some sort of way to find which pixels to fill between the two points of a line. Luckily, computer graphics have been used for decades and there are algorithms we can use that only require simple math. My first idea was to create a simple 8-bit computer to take in two points of a line, run them through Bresenham's algorithm, and output the results. I first created this 8-bit adder, followed by registers to a bus so you could send data in and out. I added some RAM to store data and was able to get a screen connected to the computer. And finally, I created a program counter along with my own compiler to convert Python commands into hex code the computer could understand. With everything finished, I uploaded the hex code of Bresenham's algorithm onto the computer, gave it 2 points, and turned it on. Well, that didn't work. Instead of getting the lines I was supposed to get, I would get a flat line or a line that was 45 degrees, which is not what I wanted since I needed my graphics card to be able to draw any type of line. When I started to debug my graphics card, I realized that it was too complicated and it could be way simpler if I built it to do work directly. If this doesn't make any sense, let me explain. For my old design to run a few calculations on a number, the number would have to be moved around the computer from the RAM to the registers to the ALU and back to the RAM. And that's just for one calculation. This type of design would be harder to debug and wasn't that efficient because most of the time was spent moving the data around and not actually doing calculations. Instead, my new design would have adders linked together in a chain, with each adder doing a part of the algorithm. This design would be larger and could only do one thing, but it would be much faster and easier to debug. And if you still didn't understand what I said, this is what my old design looked like, and this is what the new design looks like. Straightforward and easy to fix if it were to break. With that, I started building the new design. Building the new design was much simpler than the older one, because I could check it every step of the way. Here, you can see it calculating the dy and dx variables required for Bresenham's algorithm. Step by step, I built my graphics card until it was finished. I had to code another Python script to control some parts of the line renderer. With everything done, I put in the points of the line and turned it on. And this time, it worked. My line renderer was finally complete. But of course, there had to be another problem. Drawing a line that was going to the bottom right corner of the screen was working fine, but a line going in any other direction would become a flat line. After looking for the Python code in the graphics card, nothing seemed to be wrong, until I took another look at the Wikipedia page where I got the algorithm from. Apparently, the algorithm I used only covered 1/8 of all possible lines. The good news was that there was an algorithm that let you draw any type of line. But the bad news was that this new algorithm was massive compared to the last one and would require a lot of work. So again, I started rebuilding my graphics card for the first time. This time, it was a little bit simpler because the new algorithm was so similar to the old one, so I could just copy and paste some parts. With everything finished for real this time, I tried out some different types of lines, and my graphics card was finally working. But this wasn't the only thing I had to do before I could 3D render objects. You see, my line renderer can only render 2D lines and doesn't take depth into account when drawing lines. Fortunately, there's an equation I can use that converts 3D points into 2D points by using a field of view to adjust the positions of the points based on the Z value. After building this component on top of my existing renderer and attaching a ROM to feed line data in for larger objects, I was finally ready to render 3D objects. But as always, there had to be another problem. Here, I expected something similar to a square to be drawn from 3 lines. But for some reason, the lines didn't want to leave the wall and start from their predetermined points. But for once, this was a very simple bug to fix and only needed me to clear the line renderer in between every line it drew. And with that, the Turtle Card 200X 3D was finally complete. If you want to try it out for yourself, I uploaded it to GitHub along with instructions and with all the Python code. There are currently 3 templates, a weird triangle, a pyramid, and a cube. This project was pretty fun, so I'll do more of these videos in the future. This graphics card still needs to be optimized, and it'll be interesting to dive into ray tracing. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.